Power BI is one of the most rapidly growing technologies out there. But many people think Power BI as one piece of technology. But it has three distinct components: Power Query, Power Pivot, and Power BI Visuals. In this video, let me explain what these three technologies are, how they relate to each other, and how to use them with a full-length example. Let's jump in. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. I'll talk more about them during the video. Let's start by understanding the three components of Power BI in a diagram view first. So most of the time, we think Power BI as one big box. But as I said earlier, there are three layers. So the first layer is Power Query. We'll call this as PQ. The next layer is Power Pivot, PP. And the final layer is Power BI, Visuals. Now let's understand how these three work together to produce an output from your data. You have some data here. Let's just say this is your sales data or human resources data or whatever may be the case. When you want to analyze this data, the first step of interaction within Power BI for that data would be Power Query. This is the engine or this is the software that lets you connect to the data source, fetch the data, and if needed, change anything about the data. For example, for a specific analysis, you only want to look at 2021 sales, whereas your database contains sales going all the way back to 1997. You can use Power Query to specify a filter condition through which the data gets filtered, and then only the specified data for that particular year is available to you. Once Power Query finishes its job, it will publish the data to Power Pivot. We then use Power Pivot to calculate things on your data. For example, you can calculate total sales or sales per customer or what is the profit margin. All of those calculations are happening inside Power Pivot engine. The language that you use to do these calculations is called DAX. Data Analysis Expressions, DAX. Once the calculations are done, then the outputs can be visualized within the Power BI visual layer. This is where you make your graphs, your column charts, your slicers, your interactions, everything. And this is the final box that you and your audience will actually see. Whereas these two are the background layers that do most of the job. Now let's implement this process flow within Power BI so that you can understand how each layer looks, what to do within each layer, and how data goes from one layer to another layer. Let's start by opening Power BI first. For the purpose of this exercise, I want to look at the Olympic medal data from the recently concluded Japan Olympics. This data is nicely available in many places, but I prefer going it to Wikipedia. And here is my medal table. I just want to load up this table into Power BI so that we could do some analysis and produce some visuals. Because this is in a web page, my get data needs to be from web. So we'll select web connect and I will copy the URL of this page, paste it here. Notice that even though all of these steps are happening within Power BI desktop, the actual process of connecting to this web page and fetching the data is handled by the Power Query component of Power BI. When you click OK, Power Query will show you this navigator screen asking you which table or tables from the page you want to load. We shall load this 2020 Summer Olympics medal table. We'll select that and I will click on transform data. You could see that while the medal table is fairly clean, there is some extra characters like Japan has an asterisk at the end because it's the host nation, as well as certain countries do not have a rank available because they are tied with other countries. When you transform the data, all of this process happens within the Power Query editor. So here I can tell Power Query how I would like my data to be structured and how I want to see it when it is loaded into Power BI. First up, we will fill up all these nulls with the same rank as the previous country because they are tied. So we'll select the rank column, go to the transform ribbon, and then select fill down. It will fill all the null values with the value from cell above. Next up, we notice that there is a total row at the bottom and this is not required for our analysis. So I'll go to the rank, go all the way and uncheck the total row. Also, we would like to remove any asterisks next to the country name. So we'll select the team column and then
click on replace values, and we will say value to find is asterisk, replace with nothing, and that will add an extra rule saying that if there is an asterisk, it should be replaced. All right, everything looks clean. Now let's go ahead and rename this query as medals and click on home, close and apply. This is when all the changes that you have done to the data will be applied, and Power Query will run the process, get the data, clean it up, and send it to the Power Pivot engine. So now Power Pivot has access to this medals table, and from here I can build some calculations. Already the medal table is fairly clean. I can view it from the data view and everything looks nice and good. But what we will do is we will calculate percentage of gold medals as against total medals. So to calculate such a thing, we will add a new measure. But first, let's talk about the sponsor of this video, Squarespace. Squarespace is an online platform to create beautiful websites. I have been trying to create a remote Power BI trainer website using Squarespace to advertise my services as a Power BI trainer. And it is very easy to set up and customize my website. I can edit any portion of my websites in a beautifully pre-selected template and then specify what I want. One of the powerful features of Squarespace is email marketing. You can easily set up an email marketing list so that you can collect the email addresses of your prospective clients and then reach out to them with any potential offers or information about your products. So if you would like to launch your own website or a passion project, I recommend checking out squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you are ready to launch your business, visit squarespace.com/chandu, that is squarespace.com/chandu, for 10% off your first purchase. Thank you, Squarespace, for sponsoring this video. This measure, we will call it as gold percent. And this is nothing but a division of divide. Numerator is number of gold medals. So we will say sum of medals gold. You might be thinking, why can't we refer to the medals gold directly? Why do we have to sum? This is because Power Pivot expects you to have an aggregation, a sum or a count or something else for each of these parameters. So we need to provide it in that format. Likewise, sum of medals total. And then we will click OK. That gold percentage is added as a measure to our table. You can see that it is now available as a calculation. You can select this measure and apply a formatting to it. Because it's a percentage, I'm going to set it as percent with one decimal point. Now let's go and visualize the gold percentage by country in a table. We can go to the visual layer and here we will build the visual. So we'll select a table visual, and within this I'm just gonna place team and gold percentage. We'll get the values here. I'm just gonna sort this in the descending order, and you could see that Bahamas, Bermuda, Kosovo, Morocco, Puerto Rico have all 100% gold. We can also make a scatter plot to understand the distribution of medals, maybe gold versus silver. So I can put gold on x-axis and silver on y-axis and a team name at a detail level. And then we can see how various countries fare. Many countries are within the 0-0 level because they have very few gold and silver medals. But there are certain countries that have very high gold and silver medals. For example, United States has 39 gold and 41 silver. China has 38 gold and 32 silver. And when you click on one of these dots, it will also show gold percentage here by filtering the table down to just that country. Now that we got some visuals here, let's understand how all the three layers, Power Query, Power Pivot, and Power BI are working together. The actual data came from my Wikipedia page and it went straight into Power Query. So if I go to transform data, I can see my query here, medals table. The source data looked like this. Don't worry, this is the actual HTML code for that Wikipedia page. But eventually, it ended up looking like a nice table with no asterisks, and the rank is also equalized wherever there is a blank. Once this is done, we clicked on close and apply. And this is when the source data now went and sat in the data model or the Power Pivot engine. Power Pivot engine is then internally used to calculate gold percentage, as well as every little other piece of information that is shown on the screen. All these numbers, 39, 41, 38, 32, are all calculated by the Power Pivot engine. And anytime you click on a dot here, all of these interactions are also controlled by the Power Pivot engine. Power BI visuals are used to create these nice looking tables and scatter plots for you to explore and understand the data. Let's see what happens if you make any changes in either Power Query or Power Pivot layers. First up, I'll go to transform data, and let's just filter out any country that has zero bronze medals. When you close and apply, Power Query will send a new set of data to Power Pivot, which will then go and recalculate the gold percentage, because gold percentage is as against total medal percentage. And you can see that some of those 100% countries are now no longer there, because all of these, their medals are gold, hence they don't have any bronze medals and no longer they are part of the data, and now they're gone, and we now have Qatar and Slovenia and Uzbekistan on the top of the table. Likewise, I can select my gold medal gold percentage measure and maybe change some of this calculation. So for example, sum of medals gold, sum of medals total. Instead of medals total, we'll just say gold percentage as against silver. So if I change this definition of the calculation and then click OK, you can see that, for example, Jamaica has 4 times as many gold medals as it has silver. Belgium 3 times, Bulgaria 3 times. Likewise, if you change the display formatting, so for example, it now has 0 decimal points, again, the visual gets updated. So this is how those individual layers interact with the other layers. And anytime you make changes within Power Query, it will have downstream impact on both Power Pivot and the visuals. Whereas if you make a change within Power Pivot, it will only impact the outputs. It won't go back and change some things that you have done within Power Query layer. A good practice when you are using these three components is you need to be thinking specific things at each layer. So when you are working within Power Query, you want to make changes to the data or add filters or remove columns or combine tables. Within Power Pivot, you want to think about how do I calculate stuff? How do I calculate totals? How do I calculate various numbers and measures that can be used for display purposes? And when it comes to output layer, the visual layer, you are thinking about how do I present the information? What sort of a visual or a graph will look good for this data or this information that I'm presenting? How do I structure it? How do I color it? What kind of extra information can I provide here? As this example is a fairly simple one, I highly recommend that you try to replicate all of these steps if you want to understand more about Power BI.
I hope that gave you enough clarity on how all the three components of the Power BI platform work together. If you would like to learn more about the very first thing, that is Power Query, check out my video that is shown on the screen somewhere here. And if you want to learn more about all the three components, there is a playlist that is shown on the screen as well. Check it out. It talks about Power Query, Power Pivot, and Power BI in a very detailed level. Please set aside time and watch those videos, especially if you want to learn more about these things. Big thanks for watching this video, and I'll catch you again somewhere else. Bye-bye.